Hello viewers, so I hope you must have watched my previous video on research, that is Introduction to Research Design. As I repeatedly saying it, that research design is again an integral part of research process because it gives you an idea about your research plan. So in that video I have covered the point, the basic meaning of research design, what all components are to be covered in that, and what are the features of good research design. So my this video is in continuation of the previous one, in which I will be taking the major types of research design. Because when you are going for your research journey, and even when you are preparing for your examinations also, like in doctoral programs, there is a lot of, you can say, coursework examinations are there. So in that also, usually the scholar gets confused with various types of research design and types of research. Types of research is altogether a different thing, but then according to the type of research, how you are designing your research, how you will be carrying your research further, that is very important. So in that regard, this video will help you to understand the various types of research design and how they are different from one another. And with the help of my presentation, you will be able to understand various types of research design, that is descriptive, exploratory, experimental mainly, and how we frame it when we go for our research process and research journey. So here it comes, the presentation, which will explain you the various types of research design and the various types of studies it is related with.
So now let's start understanding the types of research design. As you can see in this diagram, that the main types of research design is classified in two categories. One is conclusive research design and other is exploratory. Yes, there are a lot of books which gives you the variety of research design, but in my video and seeing the paucity of time as well, I have taken those research design which are frequently used in research and are easy to understand. Because once we start our research process, first thing is to understand the easy things and then get into the complicated one. So if in this diagram you can see that the research design is majorly classified in two things, conclusive and exploratory. And then in conclusive, you can see the furthermore two categories, that is descriptive research design and causal research design. Now, moving further, first we will understand descriptive research design. As you can see in this diagram, descriptive research design, what does it give? Basically, descriptive research design is mainly provide detailed explanation of the phenomena. That means whenever you say that my research design is descriptive type, or you are doing descriptive research design, then in that case it is providing you, the research gives the detailed explanation of the phenomena. आप कोई भी काम जब करते हैं जहाँ पर आप उसे structured और formal तरीके से करते हैं, और जहाँ पर आप किसी भी phenomena या कोई भी concept जिसको आप study कर रहे हैं अपने research में, वहां पर जब आप डिटेल एक्सप्लेनेशन देते हैं, देन इट बिकम्स अ डिस्क्रिप्टिव रिसर्च डिजाइन, एज द नेम इज शोइंग दैट यस, यू आर गोना टू गिव द डिटेल्ड एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर फिनोमेना, एंड दैट टू इन अ स्ट्रक्चर्ड मैनर, एंड दैट्स व्हाई इट इज स्ट्रक्चर्ड एंड फॉर्मल इन नेचर. Now, if you can see further classification of descriptive, it is one is the cross-sectional research design, another is the longitudinal research design. And further, the cross-sectional research design is classified as single cross-sectional design and multiple cross-sectional design. Now, let's understand all these types in detail. You can see that in one column, it is written, in one box, it is cross-sectional studies, and in another column, it is mentioned longitudinal studies. We'll take it one by one and you will be getting the insights of these two things. In cross-sectional study, a specific chunk of the population is to be selected for investigation. It is scientific in approach. As I said in the previous slide, that descriptive research design is structured and is formal in nature. So in this, we select a population to be investigated and to be studied. And in single cross-sectional design, we cover the one segment of population at one point of time. Whereas in multiple cross-sectional, if I am studying different sample groups at different time intervals, and this is also called as cohort analysis. So if you are covering the single segment or one segment of population, you will say that my research design is single cross-sectional design. And if you are covering different sample groups at different time intervals in your research, then you will categorize it as a multiple cross-sectional design. So in cross-sectional, we take a specific set of population. I hope the term is clear and the detailed explanation is clear in your mind. And because it is structured, it is scientific in approach. You select the segment of a population, and then, as we always say, that yes, a sample, definitely a sample will be taken, and you will proceed accordingly. The longitudinal studies mainly covers a single sample, but in that, you will be studying that sample for a longer period of time. Now, what I am here studying means the longer period. That means if you are taking one sample and then you are studying a different time period, but the sample is same, so we call it as a longitudinal studies. Usually in case of social sciences, yes, we go for longitudinal studies, specifically in project, wherein we are seeing some effects or we are seeing some impact on the particular sample, wherein we have put in them in some experiments also. So we call it as a longitudinal studies, in which a single sample of the identified population that is studied over a stretched time period of time. It includes repeated measurement of the selected group of population. Now, this is a very important point to understand, that in case of longitudinal, because we want to see the effect or the impact or influence, whatever you say. So definitely it includes repeated measurement of the selected group of population over a fixed interval of time. But always keep this in mind, that when we go for the longitudinal study, once the sample is selected, because you are studying on that sample, so that sample needs to be constant over the period of study. Otherwise, it will affect your results. So this is a very important point to consider when we are going for the longitudinal studies. Again, it depends on the objective which you are taking in your research, what kind of studies you will consider, that is cross-sectional studies or longitudinal studies. But I hope the viewers must be now clear with the difference between this cross-sectional and longitudinal. Now, moving to the next design, that is exploratory research design. If your research covering the exploratory research design, then first of all, understand the feature of exploratory research design. It is flexible in approach and involves qualitative investigation. As in descriptive, that involves quantitative. In exploratory, it involves qualitative. And that's why, as it is flexible, you can see it is loosely structured and informal in nature. I also explained you in my earlier videos about deductive and inductive method approaches of the research. So definitely in exploratory, we move more for the inductive rather than deductive. So in exploratory research design, what you do is usually go for secondary source analysis. You go for the comprehensive case method. You are going for the expert opinion survey. And sometimes you go for the focus group discussion. These are all the ways through which you carry out your exploratory research design. We will cover all these things one by one. In secondary source analysis, what we do is, this analysis covers the details of previously collected findings and can be represented in a relatively easier way. That means we gather the information which is available and what are the findings are there, then we put it in an easier way to understand, and that's why it is called a secondary source. Secondary source, you understand, which is available already. We always talk about the primary and the secondary. So here the meaning of secondary source is that which is available. The data is available and you are collecting it and then you are representing it. A comprehensive case method. What does it mean is, the comprehensive case method, if your study talks about a particular case, so the comprehensive case method will be used. It focuses on single unit of analysis. You see that in management or in other fields or in field of law also, we focus on a single case or we take a single case. Now, what that unit can be, that unit could be an individual employee if you are working, or a customer you are taking, an organization, or a complete country. It depends on that, up to what depth you want to go in your research. So that defines your case. That is a comprehensive case method. Moving further is the expert opinion survey. Now this goes usually, if you see, in at time of elections or at the time of in general, right now also in this COVID-19, lot of time we are going for this expert opinion survey. So it is conducted when no previous information or data is available. And again, I have taken the example of this COVID-19. Right now, no structured data is available for that. So every time we are going for the expert opinion, we are taking up the opinion from the different experts of different fields, because it is affecting all the arenas of the world. So definitely we are taking up the expert opinion, and then on that we are constructing our research. So expert opinion survey is conducted when no previous information or data is available on the topic of research, and it is formal and structured in general. Yes, so when you go for this, overall the exploratory is informal, but in case of expert, Yes, you have to frame something, that's then only you will be able to interact with the experts. And the last is the focus group discussion. And you must have seen FGDs. We go for the focus group in case of the qualitative survey mainly, or in case of the qualitative research studies, which again I'll be covering in my subsequent videos about the quantitative and qualitative research and how it is gaining the importance in recent scenario. So focus group discussion is the last point to discuss in today's video. It is mainly used for the motivational studies and in social research. Now you must have seen people go for the FGDs and they extract the information from a particular group. Usually when you go for this discussion, what is the size is the sometimes the you go for the time minutes of 90 minutes to sometimes 2 hours, because you have to actually reflect and you have to state that in your research design that with how much group you have talked to, how much time you have given and what all things you have gathered, because that is a little bit loose structured, so you have to be a little bit more cautious on it. And the information which is collected by FGDs is then analyzed with the suitable qualitative methods. Now, in recent times, a lot of qualitative tools are also coming. A lot of softwares are there to analyze the things which are qualitative in nature, not in quantitative, because it is tough to convert all the things in from the qualitative to quantitative. So with this, I'm putting a pause on my video today on the types of research design part 1. I'll be again on this platform for sharing some more information on research design part 2, wherein I'll be covering causal research, that is the experimental research design. For any query, please mail on learnwithharmony@gmail.com. Thank you.